أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Welcome everybody, inshallah. We're still in our journey with the Holy Quran, the interpretation of the Quran, inshallah. This journey is a long journey, the journey of the life, the human being, the journey of the creation, the journey which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it for us to go to Jannah, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. The journey started long time ago. And I just started my tafsir before almost 6-7 years. We finished Nur al-Bayan, alhamdulillah, in 6 years, this tafsir, fourth edition. And also, I finished the tafsir, which is I'm doing now. I started from Surah al-Fatiha, Baqarah, and continuation to tonight, inshallah, the end or the last episode of Surah al-Nur, the chapter of the light. We are in episode number 15. Means we talk almost 7 hours and a half in Surah al-Nur. Explain it in 7 hours and a half. Alhamdulillah. Inshallah, last three ayat. Inshallah, we'll cover tonight 62, verse 62, 63, and 64. These are the last verses of the chapter of the light, inshallah. I have a title. Actually, I have in my tafsir two titles for these three ayat here. Two verses with one title, and the last verse with another title. But the first title is The Ethics of the Believers with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I have this title before verse number 62. What did Allah say? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله وإذا كانوا معه على أمر جامع لم يذهبوا حتى يستأذنوه. إن الذين يستأذنونك أولئك الذين يؤمنون بالله ورسوله فإذا استأذنوك لبعض شأنهم فأذن لمن شئت منهم واستغفر لهم الله إن الله غفور رحيم. The meaning of this ayah here from Nur al-Bayan, the believers are those who believe in Allah and his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when they are with him, with Rasulullah, for a collective matter, amrin jam, a collective matter for what? For the Muslim ummah. That collective matter when he called the whole of the sahaba for something important, not for private business. No, the collective matter for the whole entire ummah. طيب, this is something important. They pay attention to Rasulullah, to him. And do not leave without his permission. Like the munafiqeen, they used to sneak and they used to go away from Rasulullah for their business until they did not care about the matter of Muslim ummah. And the mu'mineen, they did not do that. They used to pay attention to Rasulullah and do not leave without his permission. Indeed, Allah said, those who seek your permission are the ones who believe in Allah and his messenger. طيب. Those who did not take permission and they sneak, they are hypocrites. But those who used to take permission for something important for their private business, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them still mu'mineen because they take permission from Rasulullah to leave. So, O Prophet, when they ask you for permission for their business of theirs, give it to whom you wish from among them. Means, this is up to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he can give the permission or not. It's up to him. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the choice. Give it to whom you wish from among them. Might be there is somebody like Abu Bakr and Umar and he has business. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, could you please let me go because I'm important. Rasulullah said, no, you are a very important man. Maybe you're going to say something we're not aware about it. You are going to say very important opinion. That's I will not let you go. So sit down here. Listen, I need your mashura, your consultation. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is up to him. He knows who can sit, who can give the good opinion or not good opinion. Somebody is not like really, go, no problem, take care of your kids. But if somebody like Abu Bakr and Umar and Abu Ubaidah and the great Sahaba, no, everybody must stay here. Khalid bin Walid, Amr ibn As, Abu Huraira, these Sahaba, they have, you know, important. They cannot, Rasulullah cannot give. But this is up to Rasulullah. And ask Allah for their forgiveness and protection. That Rasulullah has. He allowed someone to go. And he's the one, he allowed him to go to leave for that collective matter, for the Muslim Ummah. And
Allah told Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ask forgiveness for him because he left. Means Allah want everybody to stay, not to leave. That's why ask, why you ask Ya Rasulullah forgiveness for him because he leave. And Allah want everybody to stay, to talk about the matter of the Muslim woman. That very importantly, we're going to say, surely Allah is the most forgiving, very merciful. Let's see this ayah. Who is the mu'min? إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ The believers are those who believe in Allah and His Messenger. المؤمن, the one who believe in Allah and believe in Rasulullah as a مبلغ, the one who deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because you believe in Allah and you believe in Rasulullah as a messenger of Allah, the one who deliver the message, you, all of your life must be controlled by Allah and the Rasul, because you already by your choice, you believe in them, right? طيب. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم for if you see something important for the Muslim Ummah, they must call the Muslim Ummah, call everybody for a collective matter, for the important matter for the Ummah. Very important, that's why. For like war, like some enemy, they are attacking Medina, like Roman one time. He called the Sahaba, As-salatu jami'a, everybody must come to the masjid. There is a collective matter, everybody leave your business, come to Rasulullah. Rasulullah is calling you, very important. Might be somebody gonna come and they're gonna say his opinion. Rasulullah making consultation, shura, with his command. We have surah in the Quran, the chapter of the consultation. Surah al-shura, right? Very important. فالمؤمن الحق, the real mu'min, the one, if somebody called him, or he being called for a collective matter for the Muslim ummah, he must leave everything and he must run to this matter because it's very important. فالاستئذان, taking permission from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's a sign of what? Al-Iman, the mu'min. Allah said that, innama al-mu'minun. But if somebody sneak like a hypocrites and they did not take permission from Rasulullah and they sneak little by little and they escape without permission from Rasulullah, this is hypocrisy. But if something comes to you like emergency, something important for you, your business, whatever, anything like this, take permission from Rasulullah and wait for his, might be he say yes or no. And this is a sign of Iman. Very important. We are the best nation. We are the khair ummah. And we have the shura consultation between the Muslim ummah. And very important, those who been in this consultation, not anybody just a fool. No. The kibar sahaba, the great sahaba. They were the ones Rasulullah used to call them and they used to say around him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take their opinion. Ahlul mashura, ahlul ra'i, the people of consultation, those who have opinion, okay? So that's why taking permission from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's very important and it's up to him and he must ask forgiveness for those who leave and he give them permission as if Allah is telling them don't leave. That's why Rasulullah is asking forgiveness for you, for your protection too. The matters of Muslim Ummah, it's very important. Muslim Ummah's matter is very important. Better than your business, important. More than your business, your life, your family, all of that. Muslim Ummah nowadays, they became very selfish. Everybody is busy with his politics, with his money, with his treasures, with his nation. And they are separated. They are not together anymore. That's why from this ayah, we have to learn. If we come to the collective matter for the Muslim Ummah, everybody must come, must stand, must take care of the Muslim Ummah. Otherwise, this not good. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Rasulullah for those who even take permission, ask Allah forgiveness for them because they are doing something. If somebody said, my house better than al-masjid, important more than al-masjid in the community. My business, my family, important more than the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is not right. And they used to teach us, اللي يحرم على مش عارف على الجامع على البيت كلام فاضي هذا كله. الصحابة, they did sacrifice everything for the deen of Allah. Look to خديجة رضي الله عنها. Look to أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه. Look to عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه. عثمان بن عفان, عبد الرحمن بن عوف. These صحابة, they gave their children, their money, their time, their life. They gave it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إحنا we're coming for brings 5 minutes for Salah, we become Sahaba, we guarantee Jannah. Inshallah we'll go to Jannah, but anyway you have to sacrifice more.
We have to care about the Muslim Ummah because this is exactly the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Let's go verse number 63. I love this ayah so much. I love this ayah so much. Let me read it for you and then from my tafsir Nur al-Bayan and then we'll talk later about it inshallah. From my what I collected for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said verse number 63 in the chapter of Nur, the light.
لا تجعلوا دعاء الرسول بينكم كدعاء بعضكم بعضا قد يعلم الله الذين يتسللون منكم لواذا فليحذر الذين يخالفون عن أمره أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم.
صدق الله العظيم. Look at this ayah. This ayah is teaching us as Muslim Ummah to have adab, etiquette, rules when we talk about Rasulullah, when we call him and when we stand beside his grave or we mention his name, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Look at the meaning. Oh believers, Allah is still talking to the mu'mineen. Means you have to listen carefully. Pay attention. Allah is giving you order right now. Do not call the messenger the same way you call each other by name. Like Muhammad or Ibn Abdullah. You cannot say that. Somebody, I see somebody wearing suit and in the big program in the TV. Like Muhammad said, Muhammad bil'a ma'abuk huwa, inshallah. Muhammad is playing with your dad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You cannot call him by his name, Muhammad. You cannot say, Ibn Abdullah. He's not playing with you. Let me continue the ayat and I will explain. But, istidrak, but what should we do? Honor him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have to honor him. What? Saying, oh Prophet, ya ayyuha nabi. Allah called him ya ayyuha nabi. And who am I to call him Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh messenger of Allah. Oh Prophet of Allah. And lower your voice if you stand beside his grave. Even if somebody mentioned his name, you have to. If somebody say, Qala Rasulullah. Rasulullah said, listen, make it up. Listen, put your head down out of respect to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As if he's there and you are listening to him, you are talking to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's Rasulullah. He's a Muhammad Nabi Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You cannot say Muhammad. You cannot say son of Abdullah. Who said that? Have adab. This is the ethics of the believers. Oh Prophet. Oh Messenger of Allah. Lower your voice. Be polite. And Allah knows about those hypocrites who live secretly during that collective matter. When Rasulullah used to call the Sahaba, these hypocrites, they used to live secretly and they sneak out, hiding themselves under those, under the cover of others without permission. يعني imagine Rasulullah is here and he's talking to the mu'mineen and see somebody munafiq hypocrite and he make himself he's talking by the phone. Oh yeah, see, he's taking others as a zari'a, as a way to sneak. The phone, hello, yes, can I, yeah, I'm coming and there is nobody talking to him, but see, he want to make it as a hujjah and excuse just to sneak out, deliver Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa And he said, يتسللون. تسلل الحركة بتدرج يعني is going little by little, little by little. تسلل. Little by little until he goes out. Sneaking out. Allah عز وجل explaining exactly what the منافق used to do. In the ayah, سبحان الله. And he used to sneak out just to go away from what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is doing. But that's why we have to understand this ayat again. We have to honor Rasulullah by calling him Ya Nabi Allah, Ya Rasulullah. And Allah knows about those hypocrites who live secretly and they sneak out hiding themselves under the cover of others without permission. So, those who do so, beware of Allah's punishment or calamity in dunya and the akhirah. Look at this ayah. Somebody invites me for some food, I invite him for some food or Hajji. It's okay, we can do that. But when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is calling the Muslim Ummah, not for some business now, this is a collective matter for the whole entire Muslim Ummah, something important.
فthe call of Rasulullah is not like my call and your call to each other. If he invites you or I invite him. If he invites someone, Rasulullah did something important. It's not for food or for joking. And this is very important for the Muslim Ummah until the day of judgment. Or second type of dua. Dua, like what I just explained here, the call. Dua means when you call him by his name. He's not like us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, he was a human being. And Rasul Allah Azza wa Jal blamed someone, forbidden in Surah Al-Hujurat, the chapter of Al-Hujurat, that man used to come from desert. Ya Muhammad! Ya Muhammad! Like this. Muhammad is not playing with you. Well, he was a mu'min, that man. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, no. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. These people, they have no sense. How can you call Rasulullah while he's sleeping tired by his name? Even if you call him by Rasulullah, why did you call him while he was sleeping? He's tired. Give him time and then he can come to you later. You know, that man is Bedouin. He's like, Ya Muhammad! As if he's working for him. No. Even if you call him by your name, Muhammad, this is not good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't do that. What about if you call him, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Nabi Allah? He's tired, sleeping. You cannot bother him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يعني both are not good. Even if you call him by Rasulullah, Nabuwa or Risala, this is not good. فالله عز جل عابة على هؤلاء الناس إن الذين ينادونك من وراء الحجرات, those who are calling you from behind your houses, Ya Rasulullah, they have no sense. ولو أنهم صبروا حتى تخرج إليهم لكان خير لهم. If they were patient until Rasulullah came out to him, to them by himself, it's better for them. You know? But Allah said, no, don't do that. You know, don't do that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alayhi salatu wa salam, what is between us and Rasulullah? He is Rasulullah, the messenger of Allah. And you are his nation. Not because his name is Muhammad, not because he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No. I am one of the followers of Rasulullah because he is Rasulullah. He's my Rasul. He's my Nabi. Not because his name is Muhammad. I'm going to call him by Muhammad. No. When we mention his name, this is my Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is my Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I respect him so much. I love him so much. I make salah upon him so much. I can sacrifice him with my father and mother and myself and my children. Why? Because I love him and my salvation in the day of judgment because of him. He's the one who's going to give me water from Nahr al-Kawthar. He's the one who's going to intercede for me in the day of judgment. And he will not be happy until I will be safe, until I enter Jannah. That's why he is the one. Because of him, I'm Muslim. Because of him, I read Quran. Because of him, I know Allah, my God. Because of him, I'm alive. I have honor. Otherwise, might be in Egypt, I worship Fir'aun, or I worship a cow, or a tree, or I worship a rat, or worship anything else. No, he came with the light, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave us the nur, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why you have to respect him, alayhi salatu wa sallam. We have to defend him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look, let's learn from Allah Almighty Azza wa Jal. What did Allah call him? How did Allah call Rasulullah? Who am I, Mr. Batikh? Who are you to call him by his name? Muhammad said, alayhi salatu wa sallam. Itadib, khalik mu'adib. Allah, your creator, Allah Azza wa Jal. Look how he called the Anbiya, the prophets and messengers, and look how he did call Rasulullah. Look what did he say. Verse number 35, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah called Adam, Ya Adam, by his name, O Adam, Uskun anta wa zawjuka al-jannah, dwell, you and your wife into the Jannah. But he called him, Ya Adam, yes, Ya Adam, tayyib. And he called Nuh in Surah Hud, verse number 48. Ya Nuh, ihbud bi salamin minna. Land with your ark with peace from us. But what did he say? Ya Nuh, O Noah, O Adam. And he called, Prophet Ibrahim, the father of the prophets. Ya Ibrahim, قد صدقت رؤيا. O Ibrahim, did you believe the dream? But he goes, slaughter yourself. Surah As-Saffat, verse 104 and 5. See, he called Prophet Ibrahim by his name. Adam by his name. Nuh alayhi salam by his name. What about Musa? Ya Musa, innani ana Allah. O Moses. He did not say Prophet Musa or Messenger Musa. Oh Moses, I am your Lord. Surah Al-Qasas, verse 30. What about Isa, Jesus? He called him by his name too. But the name of his mom. Ya Isa ibn Maryam. Oh Jesus, the son of Mary. Anta qulta linnas? Did you tell people worship me? Said Allah. Surah Al-Maidah, verse 116. Oh, what else? What about Dawood, David, King David? Did he say King David? Did he say Prophet David? No. Ya Dawood, oh David,
we make you indeed, we make you Khalifa on earth. Ayuwa. Surah Sad, verse number 26. But when he called your beloved, my beloved Habib Rasulullah, what did he call him? Allah. Ya ayyuhal Rasul. بلغ ما أنزل إليك من ربك وما وإن لم تفعل فما بلغت رسالتك. Oh messenger of Allah, deliver that message I give it to you. If you did not do, means you did not do your job. But he called him what? يا أيها الرسول. He did not say يا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. He called him by the message. The message. And what did he say? يا أيها النبي إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا. Oh prophet of Allah, indeed we send you إن أرسلناك شاهدا إن أرسلناك شاهدا مبشرا ونذيرا. أيوة. فالله called him بالرسالة and the prophethood. طيب how can you do it and call him by his name صلى الله عليه وسلم while your God Allah your creator, he said Muhammad is different صلى الله عليه وسلم, peace be upon him, our prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is different from the prophets and messengers. Brother and sister, say يا رسول الله, قل يا رسول الله. Say يا نبي الله, oh prophet of Allah, and say صلى الله عليه وسلم. Lower your voice. The one who takes permission from Rasulullah, he was the believer, the mu'min. But those who used to sneak out, the hypocrites, التسلف, الخفية, hiding themselves, يتزحزح, moving himself under the excuse of talking to somebody else. This man, he's a hypocrite. This person, hypocrite. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned them, فليحذر الذين يخالفون عن أمره. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to these munafiqeen, those who do so, beware of Allah's punishment or calamity. Be careful. العاقبة السيئة, the bad end that you leave Rasulullah and you did not sit with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. لا تخالفوا رسول الله ولا تعارضوا. Don't stand against the order of Rasulullah. Don't contradict him صلى الله عليه وسلم. Don't nowadays say sunnah is not important. Don't say Quran is enough. If you say that, you're kafir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't. لا تخالف رسول الله. لا تعارض رسول الله. Don't say sunnah is not important. Sunnah is very important. Sunnah will Quran like this, the tracks of the train. But the sunnah above the Quran. Take it from me. Sunnah above the Quran. Yes. Al Quran is a treasure. Sunnah explaining this treasure. Sunnah لا حجية على القرآن. حجية السنة. السنة explain the Quran. But that's why you have to understand that. Sunnah from Allah. إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. It's a revelation. Whatever Rasulullah said from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, we have to understand that. Follow Rasulullah sallam. Love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we have to understand one thing. Sahaba, they were so polite with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the battle of Badr, for example, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, let's stop the army in this place. Some of the Sahaba, they don't like it. And they said, ya Rasulullah, is it? Look at the adab, the etiquette of the Sahaba, the adab, akhlaq, the manners of the Sahaba when they used to deal with Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, is it order from Allah to you that you can stop here with the army? Or it is just your opinion and you can make consultation with you? He said, no, this is my opinion. It is not the wahy, Jibreel. Because there is no talk with Jibreel. When Jibreel comes with the revelation, there is no talk. Yeah, but if Rasulullah says something from, يعني, his opinion, this is not, no, Jibreel did not interfere, or the revelation. He said, no, I am comfortable with this place. What do you think? They said, ya Rasulullah, then, if it is a consultation, we think this place is not good. And the hadith said, أَهَذَا مَنْزِلٌ أَنْزَلَكَهُ اللَّهُ أَمْ هُوَ الرَّأِي وَالْمَشُورَ. Allah give you order to stay here, or this consultation, or we take our opinion. He said, no, بَلِ الرَّأِي وَالْمَشُورَ. I want to listen to you. It is not Jibreel or revelation. And they said, this place is not good to stay here. And they told him, another places are good, better than this. And he was listening to them. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But they were so polite. And Allah said, beware. Those who are hypocrites, those who are denying the sunnah, those who are away from the sunnah, those who are, they don't have respect to Rasulullah. They don't know how to talk about Rasulullah. They call him by his name or the son of Abdullah or whatever. These people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fitna. Calamity, fitna, punishment for them in this dunya,
and in the hereafter severe punishment, painful punishment for them. And if he will be saved from the fitna, the calamity of this dunya, the punishment of al-akhirah is waiting for this people. Last verse with me, verse number 64, in the chapter of the light, chapter of nur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and I have a title already for this verse, last ayah, Allah's kingdom and his knowledge and abilities. This verse, last ayah, explaining that, talks about Allah's kingdom and his knowledge and his capability or abilities. Yes. أَلَا إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ قَدْ يَعْلَمُ مَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ وَيَوْمَ يُرْجَعُونَ إِلَيْهِ فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. والله بكل شيء عليم. ألا means remember. What's remember? When we say ألا, أداة تنبيه لشيء مهم بعدها. When we say ألا in the Quran means, hey, be attention. There is something important is coming now. Allah is going to tell you. ألا. 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 ألا what? Something important is coming. Be attention. Huh? Remember, whatever is in the heavens and the earth belongs all to Allah Azza wa Jalla. ألا إن لله ما في السماوات والأرض. Everything in the heavens and the earth belong all to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows, قد يعلم, he knows your state. ما أنتم عليه. What's going on with you? This is your state now. He knows about it. طيب, he knows all the time. ويوم يرجعون إليه. And he knows the condition in which they will be returned to him. وَيَوْمَ رَجَعُونَ إِلَيْهِ. He knows everything. He knows the mu'min. He knows the kafir. Since even before he created the heaven and the earth. 50,000 years. Before even he created the Adam. Adam. He knows the mu'min and the kafir. وَيَوْمَ رَجَعُونَ إِلَيْهِ. Again. He knows the condition in which they will be returned to him. He will, Almighty, tell them all what they had done in this life, in the life, this world life. Allah holds full knowledge of everything. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's explain this ayah in this couple of minutes, inshallah. We said, ala adat tanbih, means pay attention, means remember, something important is coming, Allah is going to tell you about it. When you see any ala in the Quran, means Allah is telling you something important is coming after. What is after? Ala. Indeed, belong to Allah whatever it is in the heavens and the earth. Is there anybody can claim that? That he own five skies or three skies or seven skies or seven layers of the earth or anything? Somebody can claim that he has a red ocean or the Pacific or the Mediterranean Sea or Indian Ocean? Nobody can claim that. It's everything. In the heaven, the earth belongs to Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he's a creator. That's it. I give you from the end. Tayyib. What is the heaven and what is the earth? The heaven and the earth, look at this. This is something new. You never heard about it. Listen to this. Quran. Look what Allah is saying. The heaven and the earth are like envelope. Like what? The envelope. Container. Tayyib. That envelope has too many things very expensive inside. Tamam? If I ask you, the envelope, you have inside that envelope, gold, diamond, money, everything has precious, expensive. And I tell you, brother, I want to buy what's inside the envelope or the envelope. Which one you want to, I can give it to me, if you can buy it or sell it or whatever. He said, no, take the envelope and give me the, leave whatever inside for me. Because it's expensive. Means whatever inside the heaven and the earth expensive more than the heaven and the earth itself. Because that this world has no value in the sight of Allah. But whatever inside, do you know what's inside the heaven? Angels, you don't know. Do you know everything on earth? No. We have alam al-mulk wa alam al-malakut. Alam al-mulk, that things you can see. And anything is hidden from you, even in this earth, you don't know everything here. Anything is hidden from you called alam al-malakut. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Yasin and some surahs. Anyway, you can understand. From this ayah, if I said the envelope is not expensive, the heaven and the earth, like whatever inside. That's why Allah said, أَلَا لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ.
Another ayah said, الملك, the kingdom of the heaven and the earth. سبحان الله. فeverything, and they said, لله ملك السماوات والأرض. لله, belong to Allah, the kingdom of the heaven and the earth. طيب, ما في السماوات, ما في السماوات, what is inside the heaven and the earth, belong to Allah. It's expensive. I consider the heaven and the earth like envelope, and what is inside, ما في, ما في يعني in, السماوات والأرض, in heaven and the earth, expensive more than, better than the heaven and the earth itself. طيب. Now, you see somebody have this Quran, right? And you see some Muslim, they read Quran, and he's hiding his money inside the Quran. He get some dollars and they put it inside the Quran and he keep it. And he putting some documents and he put it inside like this. And say the Quran, this is English, like the Quran. You're not allowed to do that. Because your documents and your money is not expensive like the Kalam Allah Azza wa Jal. Al-Quran, you have to honor the Quran. You cannot put anything inside the Quran. You cannot put anything above the Quran like this. You cannot keep the Quran dirty. You cannot hide anything inside. That's why whatever inside the heaven and the earth, expensive, precious, more than the heaven and the earth itself. Exactly like the Quran. You cannot keep anything and hide it, anything and hide it inside the Quran. You have to respect it because Kalam Allah is the best. Nothing better than Kalam Allah. That's why you have to respect this Quran. You have to put it above your head. This is very important. I told you it's something you have to understand. Nimrud, Ibn Kan'an, that man, he claimed that he's God, like Fir'aun al-Kharban. Nimrud, Iraq was in Iraq, Fir'aun was in Egypt. And when he was debating with Prophet Ibrahim, and he said, أَلَمْ تَرَى إِلَى الَّذِي حَاجَّ إِبْرَهِيمَ فِي رَبِّهِ أَنْ أَتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ. Because Allah gives him the kingdom, but not like Allah. Allah has the kingdom of everything. Allah give him some mulk, يعني. From the mulk of Allah, Allah give him little. And he claimed that he's God. And Sayyidina Ibrahim told him, Allah, يحيي ويميت. Allah can cause somebody to die and to really. He said, I can do that. Are you sure? He said, yes, I can do it. Get two people from jail to me right now. The guards, they give it to him, in front of Sayyidina Ibrahim and everybody. Kill this man and let this man go free. See, I can cause someone to die and I can let somebody to be free. And Sayyidina Ibrahim, now the prophet of logics, he gave it to him. He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْتِي بِالشَّمْسِ مِنَ الْمَشْرِقِ فَأْتِي بِهَا مِنَ الْمَغْرِبِ. Indeed, Allah brought or bring the sun from the east, you bring it from the west. يَا اللَّهُ وَرِّينِي, show me. And that خربان النمرود, فَبُهِتَ الَّذِهِ زِبِتْ. He cannot say nothing because he is not God. He owns nothing in the heaven and the earth. And Namrud can bring the sun from the west. But that's why, خلاص, no answer. فَبُوِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرُ وَاللَّهُ لَيَدِ الْقَوْمُ الظَّالِمِينَ. فَلَا تَظُنْ, brothers and sisters, don't think when Allah did create the heaven and the earth, everything is going like a mechanic itself like this, repeatedly. It's, no. Allah is الْحَيِّ الْقَيُّمُ. Since He created the heaven and the earth, everything under His control. His final judgment is all the time is ready. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's in control. That's why we say, Allahu alladhi la ilaha illa, the greatest verse in the Quran. At al-Kursi. Allahu alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy. Al-Qayyum. What's al-hayy? The ever living. Al-Qayyum. Al-Qa'im bi kulli shay'. He's the one who's in control in the heaven and the earth. Without him, there is no heavens. Without him, there is no earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People, they think, since Allah, like those who are in Russia, these atheist people, they believe in nature and they believe in, they say their life is just a circle. It's running itself. It's running itself, mashallah, mashallah. Any machine cannot run itself. One day this sun will come from the west, which is Namrud cannot do it. But one day that can happen before the day of judgment. But anyway, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything submitted to Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal, with one thing from His creature, He can destroy and He can give the life. Like what? Water. Imagine if there is no water on earth, sweet water, there is no rain, and it's a khalas drought, people gonna die. No water to even to drink. This is not exist anymore. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the evaporation, with the heat of the sun, we take it from the ocean, salty water, and it's going to the clouds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring it back to you, sweet water like this to drink. If you have machines to make this salt water, sweet water cannot be enough for one city like this city. And you need a lot of work and money to do it. Allah make it for all of His creatures. Out of His rahmah. With the same water, Allah can destroy people.
You see it. It is in the Quran since the time of Noah. You see it in Japan lately. You see it in the tsunamis here. Everywhere. Even in Mecca. Subhanallah, send the heavy rain that rain can destroy people and cities. With the same water Allah Azza will give you. وَجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. From the water Allah create every living things. But that's why you have to understand Allah is still there. Allah Azza wa Jal said, أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَى كُلِّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ. Surah Al-Ra'd, the chapter of the thunder, verse number 33. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لا يشغله سمع عن سمع. He's listening to me, to you, to him, everywhere around the world. He's listening to everybody individually. وَلَا بَصَرْ عَنْ بَصَرْ. He's looking to all of us in the same time. مُحِيط بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. He's all knowing. His knowledge everywhere, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَرَبُّكَ قَائِمٌ عَلَيْكَ. Allah is the one who is taking care of your affairs and taking care of you. Nadhirun ilayk, he is looking at you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. La takhfa alayhi minka khafiya. There is nothing hidden from you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, azza wa jal. That's why this munafiq, when Rasulullah was calling the sahaba for a collective matter, the munafiq, the hypocrites, without permission from Rasulullah, he was sneaking out, making too many excuses without permission. He left. He doesn't care about Rasulullah and he doesn't. And the Rasul said, stay, this is khair for you. Maybe Allah will send rahmah, you're going to get part of it. Ya kharban, ya munafiq. That's why Allah knows. If you sneak from Rasulullah and you did not take permission and you escape from that collective matter for the Muslim ummah and for your business and for your dunya, Allah knows about that. Allah is watching you. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal even told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't leave the sahab. Allah warned Rasulullah. سيد واصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة ولا شيء ولا تعد عينك عنهم. رسول الله was busy sometimes and these فقراء, the poor of the صحابة, بلال وسلمان وخباب, they used to stay with رسول الله to learn from him. رسول الله sometimes used to sit and used to leave for too many matters for the Muslim. Allah said no, don't leave them until they leave you, يا رسول الله. ولا تعد عينك عنهم. This order to Allah. What about this munafiq when he leave رسول الله Subhanallah, meeting or consultation for the collective matter for the Muslim Ummah. I will finish with this story. Again, I love it so much. One time, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to finish his salah like what we are doing. Alhamdulillah, we are following him. And that sahabi, that man, he used to come to attend the salah with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when Rasulullah finished the salah, he was looking for him. That man every day disappearing, just without making التسبيح البخيات الصالحات, just he disappeared and this is not good. You have to, yeah, sit 5 minutes, 2-3 minutes before the sunnah makes subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah. And the sahabi, he was little mad, and he, when he saw him, when he came to the masjid early, but he used to leave first one, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, azuhdan fina, do you know we are not important to you, that's why you just leaving us like this, azuhdan fina. You say somebody zahid, he doesn't care. We don't care about us. أزهدا فينا. وكأنه يعز على الرسول أن يرى أصحابه يحرمون من الخيرات. رسول was mad little bit at they said for him, because said this is خيرات when you sit with رسول الله. ملائكة, جبريل, رحمة, مرسي. رسول will make دعاء for you. You know, الحمد لله, we are still sitting listening to the درس, and رسول الله is not with us. إن شاء الله he's in our hearts. Imagine if رسول الله with us and he's here. Do you think you're going to leave the masjid? Oh Allah, I am sure nobody, no one of you going to leave the masjid. We are traveling to him. We love him to make the umrah or hajj. And we stay close to his grave, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asking for his shafa'ah, inshallah. We love him, alayhi wa sallam. And that sahabi, he left. And the Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who asked him, what's wrong with you? Why you leave me? Stay. This is khayrat, rahmah from Allah. You leave. Wait, make tasbihat after salah. And the man was about to cry. And he told the Rasulullah, ya Rasulullah, I love you so much, but you know, I have serious matter in my house. What is serious matter? Look, sisters, look. Sisters, those who are not praying. I have only one dress, one clothes. This is for salah. I have too many, but for work. For salah, special one, I wear it when I go to my salah. I have only one. I attend the salat al-jama'ah behind you wearing it, and I finish very fast to give it to my wife to wear it in the beginning of the time of the salah. I don't want her to miss the time of the jama'ah. She was praying alone at home, but in the beginning of the time, he did not want his wife to miss the time of the salah in the beginning of its time. He finished immediately and he take it off and he give it to his wife to cover herself while she was praying.
And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم رق له. I read another narration. He gave him his abaya, صلى الله عليه وسلم, his clothes. Garment, يعني. صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gave him his garment. And the man was late little bit until he went home. He was so happy. And his wife told him, why are you late? Look, look, the lady. Well, not because she wanna look at his eyes. He delayed her from her salah in the beginning of his time. Why are you late? And they said, this is what happened with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He asked me because I'm leaving immediately after the salah, and he was blaming me for that. I explained to him that I have one garment, I wear it, and then I give it to break it in the beginning of its time. And look what that lady, she said, man. And they said, I have this from Rasulullah, he gave me his garment. He said, man, are you complaining Allah to Rasulullah? Look, sister, now she's pushing her husband to get money even from haram. الصحابيات, the woman of the Sahaba, she used to tell her husband before he left the house, اتق الله فينا, fear Allah, don't feed us from haram, don't feed me and my kids from haram. We can be patient for hunger, but we cannot be patient for the hellfire, from the hellfire. Be careful, don't feed us from haram. And subhanAllah, that lady, she told her husband, are you complaining Allah to Rasulullah? That's your crying to him, he gave you his garment. And he said, no, no, I take it from him because when I die, make it my coffin. And the angels will ask me about Rasulullah in the grave. I'm going to tell them, this is his garment. Aywa. Look how they used to think. And some of the, they mentioned that lady, about the time her husband was, he delayed and he make her late from the salah. When he was talking to Rasulullah, she said, I was making only 100 tasbiha. She said, subhanAllah, 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 subhanAllah. She was busy. That time she was waiting for her husband, making 100 tasbiha. Subhanallah, 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 100 times. Then he came. Sister, she did not waste her time for watching TV or social media or TikTok or batikh. She was making 100 tasbiha, subhanallah, until her husband came. This is the timing. Watching time, subhanallah. We can learn, inshallah. I finish Surah An-Nur. May Allah lighten our hearts, inshallah, ya Rabbil Alameen. Tonight, with this beautiful story, just to open our eyes to, inshallah, to come to the salah, to have more nur and light in our deen, inshallah. Anyway, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, we make 15 episodes in Surah An-Nur. It is in the YouTube channel. If you want to go back 7 hours to listen to this tafsir, inshallah, I'm asking Allah to get us the benefit and the ajr for that, inshallah. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, we'll continue next week, Surah Al-Furqan, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullah khair.